What's up, everybody, and welcome to another reaction on Sikkerbæk. Hello, Sidika.
Hello.
Are you ready for the last medley part here?
Yeah.
And Jailhouse Rock, that's the familiar song. Elvis Presley, I don't know if he made it because he really didn't make many songs. He just played them. So I don't know who wrote the song here, but I just know the Elvis song because it's pretty famous. And like, it's also a rock and roll song. So is it the same, or how are they playing it? And how is this connected to the first song, the second song, and the first song? But before we judge it too much, let's hear it and see, hey, do we like it? Do we connect it? Or
it's a bit, little bit longer than the other one and the first one.
Yeah. So let's dive into it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the ending from the other song. Okay, what do you say? I know this song pretty good. Not Queen's version, never seen that, but the song in general.
I know the Elvis, version. But if I have to think about it, all three songs are connected, I can't really see it.
No, but
for me, it's three different songs.
Yeah, maybe they all are real songs, like not their own song. I don't know. What I know, this is not a song written by Queen, like Lucille and the other songs we listen to. But I don't know, maybe we think too much about it's connected, like because people call it medley, because they don't have a break, they play all three before the release stops, right? But I don't know. I really like it. I in general just love the song. It's a little different from the other one, so
I have. It feels like it's a little bit heavier, if you can say that.
Faster.
But also a little bit heavy.
Yeah, you can say heavier, because we have the rolling bass, and also again here you should be able to hit the bass really good because
I can hear it, it's loud, but it's.
Yeah, the other recording was also way. This is professional. This is also my favorite Wembley, and this because the sound and the video is the best quality, right?
Yeah.
So really, really good. I mean, I like it. I knew I would like the song, but I was also curious how Queen will play it because it's way different when you hear Elvis play it, right?
Yeah.
So. really, really nice. And I really, really like that the energy, again, like you said, more aggressive, but also just the energy in general is so loud. The drums, imagine being there, he's really used a lot of power on his drums, and the bass never, the back in the days with Elvis, it was a little more simple with the bass. There was walking bass, but he's really using and going up on the high pitch and stuff. You didn't do that much. It was more simple back in the 50s. Also like in the Lucille, I didn't say that, but they played different. It's a more modern point of view from the bass. Also the drums, they didn't play so loud drums back in the 50s.
How can you say it? Light and clean?
Light, clean and light, yeah. Like the Beatles, Beatles was actually pretty loud with the drums. Ringo Starr used a special technique to that. But in the 50s, Little Richard and stuff, it was more about, like you said, looking good. Like the Shadows, right? It was more about the look, and we don't want to be loud. It have to be beautiful and stuff. Compared to Little Richard, he had the smashing piano, right? But the bass and stuff, the drums was never really. Also, Ray Charles was never too loud like Roger Taylor. He's different kind of drummer. He's really smashing the drums. I love it. Let's take the listen to the rest. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
Dance to the jailhouse rock, let me hear. Dance to the jailhouse rock, come on. The show is all yours. Dance to the jailhouse rock. Dance to the jailhouse rock. Dance. Come on. Dance to the jailhouse rock. Dance to the jailhouse rock.
Yeah, you do it there.
Yeah.
Okay, so two interesting things happen here. Actually, really, really interesting thing. Actually, I never seen Queen, like also the guitar, Brian May and Freddie smash the microphone and being aggressive. This is the first time I see it. That's the piano, but I don't find that rude. I found that rude, like The Who. Jimi Hendrix burned his guitar, The Who destroyed the instrument. That was their message, and that's what they are known for, right? But I never seen Queen did that. I know this is early Queen, but still, was there a reason for him to do that? To do this? We also have to remember this is the end of the. Maybe they have one or more or two more encores, but this is the end of the the show. And one more
you can see.
Yeah. Yeah, part.
It's 23. Part 23 of the
24. One more thing I really found interesting. I don't know if you get that, but if you saw when he was trying to, it's all yours. Not many did sing Jailhouse Rock. He have it harder there to get the people's responding.
Yeah.
Or
maybe they don't sing that loud. You couldn't hear it very.
No, you could see his reaction. He said, "Come on." That was more, come on. You saw that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you saw that. He said, come on. And that was not, come on, like, it's good. It was more, come on. Like, so, but again, big respect for Freddie to not say F you and maybe say bad vibes. He accepted that people wasn't doing what I would say they should to... It was pretty zombie, pretty rude to him actually, because he invited them and there was just maybe a few sing, but not like a Wembley Lake Queen where all sing along, right?
Yeah.
So actually, not thumbs down to the crowd there. From our perspective, there could be more into it than we know, but also to his reaction. And I'm curious about why did he destroy the drums? Was it just early Cream, young Roger Taylor who wanted to show he can smash his drums? Oh, that's really nice, right? You know, when it was maybe inspired by The Who, they already did it at that time. I don't know. I found it really strange he doing that because I never thought Cream will be rude to their instrument because I've never seen. So I got surprised by that.
Yeah, me too.
Beside that, let me hear you.
It was good. But I still can't see how...
The connection, yeah.
The connection between the three songs. But I think they did good with the songs.
Mm. It was really good. And this song is really good, and also the longest song, really nice, catchy, page down. Sadly, the crowd ruined a little bit, but it was interesting. I can connect it too with the medley, so again, let us know. Maybe you all have said three times now, but it was interesting to listen to. This is still my favorite concert, same with Wembley, but this is early Queen, I really love it. So yeah. Besides that, amazing fast energy pace and stuff. So yeah, I want to say thank you so much for watching. And we see you next time. Keep requests coming. Subscribe, all that stuff. And you can go in description. There's Patreon and stuff if you're curious about that. And we see you next time. Bye.
Bye.